I know what you're thinking. Zach, didn't you just make an entire video ranting about how much you hate your Sugino 75 bottom bracket because it's super finicky and unreliable? And yes. Guys, I think I might be in an abusive relationship with my bottom bracket because, oh my gosh, it's so smooth. It's so much fun. It's so good right now, but I know I'm gonna hate it in probably 2 weeks. And for probably 99% of people, you should probably just go with sealed bearing components across the board. But for those few 1% of people, I am probably not one of them. But if you are one of them, loose ball bearing components may bring you an even deeper level of enjoyment to both riding and maintaining your bike. Here's the case for loose ball bearing bike parts. Welcome to another episode of 3 Minute Thursday, made in conjunction with Wabi Cycles. Be sure to check out Wabi for some dope fixed gears linked at the top of the description and some more of our videos where we teach you how to get the most fun out of your fixed gear in 180 seconds or less by clicking the card above. The reason that I hold on to my Sugino 75 bottom bracket, even though it gives me immense amounts of headaches, the most headaches I've ever experienced with my bike, is for this reason. If you get the really good loose ball parts, they are by far the smoothest riding bike components that you can buy. Ooh, it's like riding fixed gear for the first time all over again. And having this level of smoothness just makes every pedal stroke just an absolute dream. I really value the feeling of my bike. And when I have my loose ball bearing bottom bracket that is super packed in with grease and nice and finely adjusted, it feels like my top speed is faster than with a comparable sealed bearing bottom bracket, and it feels like I can ride up hills much easier with the same gear ratio, and that's something that every fixed gear rider should want. Loose ball bearing bike parts also will definitely make you a better mechanic. With sealed bearing components, while they are great for, I would say, probably 99% of cyclists, because they are just so easy to use and they are pretty dang reliable in their own right, for that remaining 1% of cyclists that wants to really dive deep into the mechanics of their bike, sealed bearing components just don't provide that, and that's where loose ball bearing components come in. Yes, loose ball bearing components are more complex, but a part of that is because they are extremely serviceable. You can take them entirely apart, get in there, and fine-tune everything. It's a much more intimate experience when you're working on your bike because you have to completely deconstruct the parts to make it work right. If you're somebody that just really appreciates mechanical things, you will really enjoy working on loose ball bearing parts and really enjoy that moment where you put everything back together and when you ride your bike down the street and it is the smoothest experience you've had on a bike. You will definitely find it extremely satisfying. If you like it when things just work, pretty much all the time, no matter the season, no matter the humidity and the air, then you should probably just stick to loose ball bearing components at the expense of losing on about 10 to 20% of extra buttery smoothness. But if you're in that incredibly small percent of cyclists that really likes to get your hands dirty and have an insane amount of control over the way your bike feels, and you like stuff that's built to last for a lifetime, and you want the best riding experience that you can have, period, regardless of the headaches and regardless of the time that you have to spend maintaining it, maybe you should get yourself an NJS bottom bracket. Maybe some Dura-Ace hubs, eh? Huh? You might like that. Let me know in the comments below what you think about loose ball bearing components. And also, if you have any video ideas for 3 Minute Thursday, leave that in the comments below. Thanks again to Wabi for sponsoring this video series. Check them out linked at the top of the description. And Fixie Famous shouts to Zane Kolnick, Ryan Witz, Robbie Undaya, Kelvin Ho, Justin Javier, Julian Corona, Henry Grant, David K, and Brandon Black for helping to make these fixed gear videos possible through their support on Patreon. And remember to ride your bike every day because life is short, but don't make it shorter. So, ride every day to be reasonably dangerous.